further enhance his knowledge of yoga. He has also learned basically starting his career in 1978 from Pandit Balakrishna Sharma, who imparted him the initiation, rather we can say, in the field of yoga. Thereafter, he also acquired a knowledge in 1985 from Guruji D.K.S. Iyengar. Thereafter, he has developed this subject to such an extent that he has formed his own publication in 2014, the Sutras has been written by him by the name Adi Yoga, which has been recognized and published by Bharati Vidya Bhavan also. It's a very big list. If I keep on talking about him, so in short, we have a person before us who is very capable of delivering a lecture, or rather, he is a person who will meet to our expectation of individual as well as the expectation of everybody. So without taking much time, I invite you for the further class.
Hello, namaste. I will try to talk without using the mic first. After 5 minutes, if you feel I need a mic, then I will use it. I think my voice is quite loud.
So what happened is, I got this message from NVSG. I should give a speech to the alumni, and the members are doing MA, PhD in Harvard. So I thought that probably you know more than me about this topic, which he gave. Does everybody know the topic?
Yes.
I wrote because I used to give this course in US for registered yoga teachers course. So when I was giving this course, it was 20-hour course, and I saw that everybody brings different book and they have studied different books, and what I am talking is totally different from what they are reading there. So just to make it more simple or standardized, I wrote this book, and this book is now used by many people. Actually, due to this book and my commentary on this is in 18 DVDs. So due to that, Pravita actually got interested in it because she saw my speeches on the YouTube. So this is Yoga Sutra's book. And then Pravita and Lakshmi, they asked me to do PhD course. So I applied for the same PhD course what you are doing here. And it did not work out because of the requirements of Kalidas CJCD. That I did not have MA in Sanskrit or philosophy. So then they asked me to apply to SVS. And the SVS also did not work out due to the timing, because in May and June generally I am not in India. They wanted me to be there and go. So what I did was, my PhD application to SVS, I had to write a synopsis. And this authentic yoga system, it is actually Adi Yoga, not Adi Yoga. It is pronounced like this. And Adi is Adi Kuntaha Yoga. Yeah. That is authentic yoga system. That is a word given by Dr. Friday. So my synopsis I wrote in terms of sutras. And that synopsis went to various universities, and Berkeley University, they told me that that synopsis is what we did, so I should not go and do PhD this time. So I wrote the commentary on my own sutras. Then Dr. Friday, I think many of you know him, he knows me for 50 years. He converted this into Sanskrit sutras. There is another poet scholar who wrote that. He also made Karika Lama. Different forms. English sutras which are mine, commentary is mine, and then Sanskrit sutras written by Dr. Friday. I think they are linguistically better than Dr. Friday's sutras. And Karika is written by so this book is written by Ravina of Ravina. This has got chanting of my sutras, accompanied by comes with two instructional audio features. Now, this chanting sutra is a very important part because you want practical results. So I just want to tell you that. I will write what you have here.
Certain tips which you want, practical tips, I will write here. I will just write what I feel. You do not have to do that. I already know that. I have taught yoga to around 20,000 students so far in many countries. And I can honestly tell you that there are not more than 10 best students I have. And there is none of them is Indian. So yoga is a very difficult topic to practice. It is, studying is also maybe difficult, but practice is really very difficult. And that is one tip that you should practice it every day. Even if you are doing wrong yoga, go on doing it every day. If you think you are doing wrong, do something mild and go on doing it. So suppose you are doing something mild every day and go on doing it. Like every day you should do, suppose you decide 1 hour. 1 hour is not really a lot of time. If you want to become expert, you have to do 1 hour, it's not a long time. So go on doing it every day. After some time, you will find something is happening. What is happening, nobody can tell you. You yourself have to feel it. Actually, there are certain yoga teachers. I do not know how many yoga teachers you have seen. But there are some yoga teachers who do not tell you anything. For example, Dr. Thite is my Sanskrit teacher for last 50 years. And I can tell you, he has not taught me anything. He has never taught me that this is verb, this is like this. He only talks about some other things with me. From that, I have to guess that what he means is this. For example, he will say something like, he will say, Tattva Vaisharadi.
then he is expecting me to go and find what Tattva Visharadi is and read it, and only if I get some question from that he might answer. But he will only answer like 5%. So he's been doing this for 50 years. So I'm very much used to not being taught. Lot of the things which I, even in the exercise field, I developed most of the exercises myself. If you go to my yoga exercise class, you won't find those exercises in the textbook. Those are my own exercises. If you take my teacher training, you have to form your own exercises. And that is the homework you have to do. So my first tip is that if you are really interested in the yoga knowledge, you should really practice every day. Also in very complex topics like Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Patanjali Yoga Sutra is a very complex topic. It is probably complex because he has made it like that. I do not know why it is so complex, because there are so many problems come when you start studying it. Even the people who are expert, who have studied before also, they find little bit confusion when they start explaining. And it is very difficult to know whether he purposefully did like that or whatever. But if you want to study Patanjali Yoga Sutras, I think you have to study them every day for maybe 10 years, each sutra. And for doing that, this Professor Masbro already told you in his speech last time I was there here at Luckily I attended. He also has written comment on my book. But this is a very important part if you are a philosophy student. And just yoga, mainly practice. So these are the tips. Okay. So now, I will start this discussion with the some of the things I will only give you reference. So you can study them later. Let me bring this. Now, this part I will write in the middle. Samapatti. Is there anybody here who doesn't know what Samapatti means? Anybody here who doesn't know what Samapatti means? Anybody can cite a sutra from Yoga Sutras?
Sir, would you please use the blackboard?
Why?
Because it is that...
It is reflecting.
It is for projector. It is not
it
for...
It can be rubbing. Madam, it can be rubbed.
It can be rubbed.
It doesn't need to be rubbed.
I understand. You are able to see it,
ma'am.
So, anybody can cite the sutra? Now, we will start with this sutra, and this is what basically it means. So, I am going to tell this meaning in a very common language. If you want to read it more, you can read this, any commentary, or especially Vajaspati, the Vyasa Bhashya. But, what he is telling is this, that this Samapatti thing is really part of one important terminology. It is called Samadhi. Most of the people know what this Samadhi means. When you look at this word samadhi, samapatti is coming in the Yoga Sutras. There is samadhi word in many, many different yoga topics. All samadhis are not exactly matching with Yoga Sutras. But samapatti definitely is coming under Yoga Sutras. And samadhi word, when you look at it, you have to see the Yoga Sutras definition of samadhi. Now, what happens is that first thing is Yoga Sutras is a part of the Shat Darshana, you already know that. And there is an objective of writing that. That means there is one goal in the Yoga Sutras. That goal you have to understand. Because when you understand that goal, you will know whether it has any relation with application in daily life. So, anybody wants to tell what the goal of the Yoga Sutra is? That is the sutra. What is the goal?
Kaivalya.
Kaivalya is the final goal. Kaivalya is the final goal. So, daily life has to end. Only daily life, when it ends, then only you are going to get Kaivalya. Kaivalya is not obtained in this life. Kaivalya is obtained after this life is over. So, Kaivalya cannot be applied to daily life. That is, whatever activities you are doing in the daily life, they have to be applied to get Kaivalya. Not that Kaivalya has to be applied. Because you will find today in most of the yoga fields, the yoga topics are applied for achieving material ends. That portion is not there in the Patanjali. You have to understand that Patanjali is not telling you to get weight loss, flexibility, or even for diabetes. So, in the Adiyo, I have added many other sutras to account for that. Also, Patanjali has some other things missing which I have added there. But the Kaivalya is obtained after the daily life is over. Before that, during daily life, you have to get one goal. And that goal is samadhi state. That's defined as different goal. But what I want to tell you is this. Coming to the practicality, samadhi goal is not useful in the daily life. That means the person who gets samadhi state, he cannot perform the daily activities. If you are already in a samadhi state, you cannot perform daily activities. We are not talking about samadhi from some other meaning of samadhi. Samadhi can be feeling happy all the time, or you are equanimous in the lake, or you have got your prajna is pratishthita and all that. That's what we are not talking about. Patanjali is samadhi. If you get samadhi state, you cannot perform the daily activities. So you have to understand this, that a samadhi is possible if you are not interested in daily activities. So, if you are a student of samadhi, you have to understand this, that samadhi is, you have to be very highly interested in that topic. And that highly interested is written in the Patanjali also. I will only quote maybe two sutras, let us say. One is Eva Samvekana Asana. Is you have to have a very intense desire to do that, very intense. And that intense desire must be converted into intense practice also. So, unfortunately, today if you meet all the world famous yoga teachers, you will find this. They generally don't talk about samadhi state. Even samapatti they don't talk. Most of the yoga teachers talk about asanas, pranayam, little bit talk about kriyas and like that. And that is fine because their goal is related to those practices. I asked this question once in one temple. It was a Krishna temple and I asked them this question. There are three questions I asked. I will only tell you two of them. One question I asked was that if Lord Krishna comes just now physically, how many of you are ready to give up everything and go in? You assume that it is physically coming. I am telling you, only one hand out of 150 was raised. The next question I asked was, how many people want to lose weight? 50% were hands were up in the Krishna temple. It's a famous Krishna temple in Virginia. So what I want you to understand is, I'm not trying to tell you what you should be doing. I'm just telling you that if you are interested in samapatti or samadhi or things like that, you will be very highly interested. Another example similar to that is classical music. She is in classical music. She knows that if you want to learn classical music, you have to be very, very interested in it. One person asked me that I should try to tune my voice to Tanpura. It took me 2 years, I'm just telling you. I was honestly doing it for 2 years, and then that person told me that I reached around 30 to 50% matching. So to get samadhi state is not a joke. It is very difficult. There are many people who will tell you that they got samadhi state because they want you to come to Deva or something like that. But to get a samadhi state, if you meet a person who has samadhi state, what are the things should happen? I will tell you a couple of things. I already told you that I disclaimed whatever I say, you have to take it and judge it. But suppose you see a person who has attained the samadhi state, that person will not be fearful of anything. If president tells him that he will be hanged tomorrow or his job will be lost, there will be no effect on that person. Also, I will tell you another very interesting. Generally, a person who has reached high levels of samadhi, it's not always true, but I'm just telling you, in general it is true, that person who has reached high levels of samadhi, he will not be able to store money and property. It's impossible. So if you are going around and you want to see and you feel that this person has reached samadhi state, you can try to verify what I'm saying, or you can, maybe you'll find some exceptions are there. But generally a person who has this samadhi state, he will not be interested in holding money or like that. Maximum he will be interested in day to day life. There will be no value of that. So if you read different books on topics like Tukaram's work or something, you will find that in the people who, sometimes they are guiding the kings who have money, but they themselves do not hold the money. Money means any kind of property, they cannot hold it. It is not possible for them to hold it. Even for doing good work, they cannot hold that money. Why they cannot hold that? I am not going into that. I am just telling you that when you talk about samadhi state, you have to understand that samadhi state is a result of very intense practice. Very, very intense, in too much interest. So it is not going to come by ordinary interest. Now, I am not telling you that you should have that interest or how to create that interest. My personal belief is like this. My personal belief is certain interest you already have to have. Unless you have that interest, you will not go into that. I was very interested in yoga study. I got fired 3 times in the university. I was teaching yoga study in the office, cleaning office also. So what happens is that you should have an interest by which you cannot do otherwise. That much interest you have to have in that field, then you are likely to get that knowledge. So you can imagine what kind of interest. Now once you have some interest, that interest can be kindled. Like Balagandhar, if some interest is there, then it can be kindled. But it is very difficult to create that interest. So if your child doesn't have much interest in physics, don't force him. It's not going to happen. It's only going to create unhappiness for him and you both. Once unhappiness settles, it will be distracted mind, cannot be focused. So anyway, samadhi state is the goal which you have to attain in this life. And then kaivalya is if you have exhausted the past. But here, this word, you already know this word. Can anybody define something else? Those are the least one. Can you define that?
Maintenance.
See, the human being, you already know this, the same question was asked to Professor Mark. You know this stuff, Jitter. Actually, this Jitter is in Vyasavarta of Kantasara. When this Antakara is active, then it has modified itself. And this, when you are in Samadhi state, this also you know already.
Common grounds,